14 is moving and about to begin. Can't put me finger on what lies in store, but I feel what's to happen all happened before. A father, a mother, a daughter, a son. The threads of their lives are all wrapped and done. Something is needed to twist them as tight as a string you might use when you're flying a kite. Chim chim a dee chim chim, cherry chim chom.
Archive
spy, I'll be right.
Oh, Admiral! Rickerby!
Morning, Admiral! Again?
Dark clouds gathering at number 17, a storm warning to repeat.
All London's byways where I golf speak happy. This one's the hardest to find on a map. Cherry Tree Lane, as sweet as a song, but the nannies who come here better stay for long.
Wage.
We'd better tomorrow, or they may do nothing with
me. I would stress that.
Father, what
that you're holding, dear?
We was not an advertisement.
What on earth?
George, I think we should hear it.
Take it down your theatrics.
It won't hurt to listen.
Wanted, a nanny for two adorable children.
Adorable? Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheery disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's what I did.
Play games, all sorts. You must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and very pretty.
Look at the ridiculous things.
Oh, George, please.
Take us on outing, give us treats. Sing songs, bring sweets. Never be cross or cruel, never feed us castor oil or gruel. Love us as a son and daughter, and never smell of barley water. I've that too. If you won't score and dominate us, we will never give you cause to hate us. We will hide your spectacles till you can't see.
Put toads in your bed or pepper in your
Harvey Nanny, many thanks, sincerely.
Jane, not Michael.
Thanks.
That is quite enough, Tommy Rot, for one day. Will you please go upstairs and let me get to work?
Oh, they were only trying to help.
It won't help anyone to make me late. Where's my hat?
George, dear?
Hats!
Hats! Don't you put it down here?
Hats!
Hats! I don't know how you'll be disappeared.
Yay! Take a fine cabin.
Oh, there it is!
Gather kind of wine.
Brush it with boot polish.
George and Winifred Banks live here, do they not?
Mr. and Mrs. Banks live here, yes.
And you are looking for a nanny?
Well, I suppose.
Very well then, now let's see. Play games all sorts, which I most certainly can. Take us on outings, give us treats.
Michael, it's our advertisement.
Rosy cheeks and fairly pretty. There's no objection on that score, I hope.
No, none at all.
I'm glad to hear it.
But to take that up with Mrs. Banks. She manages all that side of things. Nothing domestic has anything to do with me. Don't forget the references.
I make it a rule never to give references.
But I thought it was usual.
Oh, a very old-fashioned idea to my mind. The best people never acquire them now.
I see. Well, you will have every third Thursday evening off from 5 until 9.
The best people get every second Wednesday, ma'am, from 6 until 8, and that is what I shall take.
I see. Well, it's all settled then.
As long as I'm satisfied. I'll see the children now, thank you.
Oh, of course. You'll find they're very nice children. Can you come down now, dear?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
I wish I had them. No trouble at all. Now, children, this...
Mary Poppins, Jane, don't stare, and close your mouth, Michael, you're not a codfish.
No, let's go forward, big box. Mrs. Brown, we have a new nanny.
She passed the interview.